Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Welcome to Gospel Temple Worship Center. We're going to go to the Lord in prayer. Hope you had a wonderful Christmas. And let's just go to Him in prayer and ask Him into this place to minister. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, we come before You with humbled hearts and thankful hearts, Lord. We thank You for the year of 2018. Even though it's been a most challenging year, Lord, we know that through those times of trials and those dark valleys, Lord God, You said You would never leave us nor forsake us. You're not like mankind. You are God and God alone. Lord, we lift up Your name today. Lord, we ask Your Spirit to come. We ask that You come into this house, Lord, and we ask that You rule and You reign, Lord. Have Your holy way, Lord God. Have Your way according to the purposes that You desire in this house and in these hearts. Lord God, we ask for Your anointing upon the music, upon the singing, upon the preaching, everything that is done, the instruments, Lord, even upon the sound booth, Lord, and the recordings, all of that, Lord. We ask Your anointing because with Your anointing, Lord God, it breaks yokes. It breaks those things that bind us, those things that cause us to walk behind. Lord God, we ask this day that You come into this house. We want to lift up the name of Jesus, the name that is above every name, because at the name of Jesus, every knee will bow and every tongue will confess that You are Lord. You are Lord of all, Lord of all. And Lord, we thank You and we praise You for who You are. You are God Almighty. You are God of the universe. And we decree and we declare Your will, Your kingdom come, Your will be done on earth as it is in heaven, Lord God. May this be a place of heaven on earth, O God. We decree it, we declare it by Your Spirit in the mighty name of Jesus. And we thank You for it in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen, amen. Go ahead and stand to your feet. Who came to praise and worship our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ this morning? Did y'all come? Expecting a mighty move of God to flow through this place? Come on, y'all better wake up. Y'all better wake up, amen.
Just a few more weary days.
Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be your glorious name. Blessed be your name when the sun's shining down on me, when the world's all as it should be. Blessed be your name. Blessed be your name on the road marked with suffering, though there's pain in the offering. Every blessing you pour out, I'll turn back to praise. When the darkness closes in, Lord, still I will say, blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be your name. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be your glorious name.
Blessed be, blessed be the name.
Blessed be your name. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be your glory.
Blessed be your name. Come on. Blessed be your name when the sun's shining down on me, when the world's all as it should be. Blessed be your name.
Your name. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be your glory.
You give and take.
You give and take away. You give and take away. My heart will choose to say, blessed be your name.
You give and take. Go ahead and be seated. Welcome to Gospel Temple Worship Center. Amen. The rain scared a few of us away, but that's okay. Maybe we're recovering a little bit from our Christmas feast. But so glad that you guys are here with us here this morning. We want to welcome our visitors as well. You are our VIPs. Very important that you are here and that we welcome you into our fellowship here this morning. And we invite you to come back next week, 2019. Amen? Amen. So we welcome you with open arms. This is a church family. We pray for one another. We serve with one another, we grow with one another, and we just invite you to step into our fellowship and step into our membership. This is a family, and we look forward to greeting you. There is a visitor card in the seat in front of you. If you could please fill that out as the offering bag comes by, drop that in. We just want to put a face with the name, and during fellowship, I would love to take a chance to meet you and greet you here this morning. Amen? All right, so let's dive into the announcements. Faith Force Youth Night is going to happen this evening. Is it going to happen? Yeah. Is it happening? Okay, 6 o'clock. I ask that because we also have a members meeting that happens at 5 o'clock here in the fellowship hall. So at 5 o'clock, there's going to be a membership meeting, a members meeting here in the fellowship hall, and there's going to be food, there's going to be fellowship, and there's going to be conversation. Amen? So make plans to come out to that. There is no prayer-focused gathering tomorrow night because of the new year. So go ahead and celebrate that time together with your family. There is a prayer focus. So if you are interested in knowing what that focus is, come and see me or Melanie Gibson. I'll point you out to her if you are interested in finding out what the focus is for this coming week. There are also sign-up sheets in the foyer for two different classes for the Sensational Seniors, one for a candle-making class and one for a wreath-making class. Each one of these classes are at Moore Botanical Gardens in Lake City, and there is limited seating for this event, for these two classes. So if you are interested in going to either one of these two, there's one on the 12th and there's one on the 24th. But there is a sign-up sheet in the foyer, so if you can go ahead and sign up today for any of those two classes that you are interested in taking because of the limited availability for these classes. Also, we have our new bulletin, which is in the foyer. So if you want to get a glimpse or a calendar of all the events that are happening, these are available today as well. Short and sweet, go ahead and stand to your feet. Welcome your neighbor to the house of the Lord. Tell them how excited you are to see them and check up on them as well. Amen.
Yeah. Good morning. As you're finding your way back to your seats, hint, hint. I just want to wish everyone a happy new year. And we know that the best is yet to come. Amen. So for today, I just want to kind of give you guys an assignment. Everybody say, oh, that's what I hear from my students every time. But I just want to kind of give you some encouragement and just we're going to just decree and declare some things over this house for this coming year. So the next couple of weeks, I'm actually going to start talking about the Jewish calendar and give you some insight about some numbers and some dates in the Jewish calendar. But this week, I want you to reflect on this past year, where you are and where you want to go as a person and as a family unit. So we know that we all have assignments. Before we were created in our mother's womb, before time began, we were made with an assignment to fulfill and to accomplish. So this week, I want you to take a couple of moments and ask the Holy Spirit about your assignment for this coming year. I want you to write your vision down for you as an individual, but don't leave your family out. Write your vision down for your family and where you want your family to go. I'm not going to say New Year's resolution, because if you're like me, when I say my New Year's resolution means I'm going to start for about a week or two and then I'm going to give up. Amen? So this is going to be our vision, our focus. We're going to get focused on something individually and as a family unit and also as a body of Christ here at Gospel Temple. So I want you to ask the Father, what is his vision for you in this church, in this body of Christ as well? Where or what is he calling you to do here? I just want to encourage you not to allow the enemy to plant seeds of bitterness or create thorny areas in your heart. We know that a defiled heart will not perceive things in the light of God, but instead will misconstrue the truth about others. Be careful who you are listening to. Our view will become distorted when we start listening to the wrong voice or voices. As we come before him with clean hands and pure hearts, he will then begin to flow through us unhindered. I want him flowing through me unhindered, nothing clogging or stopping up the way. When we walk in his authority and demonstrate his kingdom on earth, the more of our assignments we are fulfilling. Do not be afraid to go into the enemy's camp and take back what has been stolen. There are gates and doors that's waiting for you to walk through. When you walk through them, shiftings and accelerations will occur. So right now, I decree and declare that God is ordering at this very hour in our lives, in this church, in this region, his plans, his divine will, which cannot be foiled. It's time to set our house in order, calling us higher. I decree and declare that the cycle of life is expanding with our due portion. Prophecy, second chances are in queue in the courts of heaven, bringing us into a time of prophetic fulfillment and our destiny. I decree and declare that God is bringing new order to every place. that's been out of order, and he is setting us up for greater things than these to appear. I decree and declare that answers to your prayers are right around the corner.
Yes.
And the spirit of delay is broken off of you and every one of us in this church in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen.
Hallelujah.
We take that, Miss Melanie, as truth in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. You know, as we go through life, we go through dry spells and difficult times, and we get busy. I think the biggest thing that the enemy uses against God's people today is keeping us busy in all kinds of things. I find myself wrapped up in that myself, and I begin to think more on those things and begin to put more emphasis on what do I need to do to accomplish this and to accomplish that. Well, that's the good thing about God. He's always there. And if I can just slow down, I can just stop. God will speak to me. Again, he's done that again this week. You know, I was going through, we had Christmas, and what a beautiful time of year it is. What it's really all about, you know, the gift of Jesus to mankind from the Father above. What a great season it is. But we get so busy with our parties and gift giving, and those things are all good. I really enjoy the time that I get to spend with my family, the fellowship that we have when we're all together. I really enjoy that. But it keeps us so busy, sometimes I think we put God to the side. And God really needs to be number one. It needs to be our first priority. Because when we put God first, I have found that when I make the effort and I put God first, all these other things will line up. I'll be a better husband. I'll be a better father. I'll be a better brother, a better son, a better friend. When I put God first, he's going to make sure these things that need to be done, they'll get done. It's when I'm trying to accomplish all these things on my own that I don't do as good as I could do and should do. Well, as I was going through the week, as usual, God gave me a verse to share with you. And it comes from Philippians 15:13. And it says, may the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace in believing through the experience of your faith, that by the power of the Holy Spirit you will abound in hope and overflow with confidence in his promises. I said, well, you know, that's a great verse, God, but what are some of your promises? And this is some of the promises that I want to share with you. And he's got many more, but these are five I want to go with you. Number one, God loves you unconditionally. You know that? God loves you unconditionally. Listen. How do we know that? See, I don't really want to tell you things that I don't have the Bible to back it up, because my words are not powerful. My ability is not good for you. What I can do for you won't help you accomplish what you need to accomplish and be who you need to be. But listen right here. I know this because listen in Romans 8:38. It says, for I am convinced that neither death nor life, neither angels nor demons, neither the present nor the future, nor any powers, neither height nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God. That is in Jesus Christ our Lord. See, that's how I can tell you today confidently, God loves you unconditionally. Look at promise number two. You are redeemed and have eternal home in heaven. Again, I just want you to take that as what I think is a good thing to tell you. Listen to what it says in Psalms 12:1. The Lord watches over you. The Lord is your shade at your right hand. The Lord will keep you from all harm. He will watch over your life. The Lord will watch over your coming and your going, both now and forevermore. Today, tomorrow, and through all eternity, this all-powerful God is watching over us. Amen. Look at number three. God formed you with intention and knows you intimately. Most of us probably know this verse here in Psalms 139. It says, for it was you who formed my inward parts. You knit me together in my mother's womb. I praise you, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Amen. Look at number four. God's plan for your life is to prosper you and to harm you. And most of you will know that verse. In Jeremiah 29:11, it says, "For I know the plans I have for you, says the Lord, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you a hope and a future." Amen. That's to God. That's some of his promises. That's four. Look at the five. And then we go to God in prayer and believe him for these things. Number five, you have special strength available to you through faith. That's us. Through our faith in the Lord Jesus Christ, we got a special strength available to us. The best resource that is available to you is the power of Christ. One of our favorite verses, Philippians 4:13, says, "I can do all things through Christ who gives me strength." Amen? That he's talking to each and every one of us who believe upon his son Jesus. He's prepared. He's ready to see all these promises come true in your life. He's able to do that. Amen? You know, normally at this time we'd ask you to lift your hands if you have a need. But see, God knows your needs, and I'm not going to ask you to do that today. As we go to God in prayer, I want you to lift that need to God. He knows it, and just come in agreement with him by the Holy Spirit that God's meeting that need. He's already prepared to take care of all of your needs. Another promise that he gives us, okay? Let's go to God in prayer. Father, I do thank you so much for your promises. Father, they're true. You speak only truth. And I'm thankful for what I was able to share with the people today. And I ask God that we will be confident in who you are. And Father, we'll take these promises, just these five promises, and there's many, many more that you give us through your word. That's why I love your word. That's why I read your word daily. Because the promises that you give me, the confidence, the peace, Father, that I receive from you through your word. And Father, as we come to you today as needy people, Father, we're facing a big decision right here in this church. This congregation of people are going to come together. And Father, we put this in your hands. Because God, we're not able to do that. We're only men and women of flesh. But through the power of your Holy Spirit, we can do all things, is what the word teaches us. So Father, we're asking that you would take this group of people today. And Father, we'll begin to lean more on you. We'll begin to seek you even in a greater way. We'll dive deeper into your truths. And Father, we'll become more like your son Jesus, that we can be effective in this community. That Father, we can reach out, as we had an opportunity last Sunday to go to the town of Timminsville and to share your love, that we can even do that even in a greater way. That we can care, meet the needs of the people through you by your hand. And Father, we're thankful for that today. Father, I just pray over this congregation today as these needs have been lifted up to you in the name of Jesus and by the power of your Holy Spirit, Father, we'll begin to see your life shining through us, that we will be the light of the world that you've asked us to be. And Father, we thank you for that privilege to even do that. In Jesus' name we pray. Hallelujah. Amen. Let's stand with me, please. Let's get ready to do our financial declaration together. As we tithe and give offerings, we believe that we receive from God jobs and better jobs, raises and bonuses, benefits, sales and commissions, favorable settlements, estates and inheritances, interest and income, rebates and returns, bills paid off, debts demolished, royalties received, gifts and surprises, checks in the mail, blessing and increase. Thank you, Lord, for meeting all of my needs, that I may have more than enough to give into the kingdom of God and to promote the gospel of Jesus Christ. Amen. Hallelujah.
I'm Your glory fill this temple.
Let's give him some praise this morning. Come on, isn't he worth it? He overcome the world. Let's give him some praise. Let's worship him. Just worship him. Just worship him. Come on, in your own voice, just worship him. Raise your hands. Worship him. Worship him. Hallelujah. 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 Just worship him. Just worship him. And fill the atmosphere. Your glory, God, is what our hearts long for. To be overcome by your presence, Lord. Your presence, Lord. And let us become more aware of your presence. Let us experience the glory of your goodness. Let us become more aware of your presence. Let us experience the glory of your goodness. Oh, your goodness, Lord. Oh, God. Oh, we thank you, Father. Father, thank you so much for your presence in our life, for your presence in this service. I thank you for bringing us together, that sending out us here together so that we can worship you, that we can praise you, that we can give you thanks for all that you have done and all that you continue to do in our lives, God. We're so thankful. We are so thankful for what you're doing in this church with this fellowship of believers, that we are so thankful and we come to you before your face. And we just honor you, and we give you praise. And I pray that the word here today does not come out and come back void, that it falls on good soil, that we will receive the word of God, that we will receive what it is that you have for us in this day, in these last days, God. We are just trusting you completely. We are trusting you. We are hearing you. We are opening our ears. We are opening our eyes for what it is that you want to show us, because you want to show us something. You've been trying to show us for so long. And I pray that this church, that everyone here today will open their eyes and open their hearts and their spirits. And they just welcome you into their lives and draw closer to you, because that is where the power stands. It's closer to you, God. It's not anything that we can do, but it's closer to you, God. It is your battle. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, God. Thank you, Jesus, for all that you've done and all that you continue to do. And we glorify you. It is not for our glory, but it is for your glory. Everything that we do, every breath that we take, every step that we take, and we thank you for every breath that you've given us life, and that we will know completely the light that shines within us, that we will have our identity in you locked in place. And God, we are thankful for you, God. We're thankful for the sacrifice of your Son, Jesus Christ, to die for our sins. Oh, and I pray this word that comes out of my mouth is not from me, it's from you. That if anything that I say here today is from my lips and from my tongue, I pray that you will bind it up. And that everything that I say is coming directly from you, from your heart for this people, for all of us. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' holy and mighty name, we glorify you. In Jesus' name, we pray. Amen. Amen and amen. Woo. Woo. The kingdom of God has come near to you. Amen. I said the kingdom of God has come near to you. Do you feel it? I'm thankful for his presence. Are you thankful for his presence in your life? Are you thankful for his presence in your life? I'm so thankful for this opportunity just to share the word of God with you and to share what God has been placing on my spirit this week. And actually, this when I was asked, it was around Christmas, the elders asked me to speak this Sunday. And I'm just so thankful to be up here. This podium, this pulpit, I've said it before, I'm so humbled by it. Just the opportunity to share with you the gospel of Jesus Christ, my Lord and Savior. He has fired me up today, and I hope and I pray that you will receive the word of God, that he will also fire you up. Have you come to receive the word of God? 2018 has been a year. It's been a year of shifting. It's been tough. It's been challenging. But it's been full of blessings. It's if you think about 2018, actually it starts back. I'm gonna talk to you guys today. 2017, the end of 2017, Miss Donna Carter, she's not here inside here right now, but Miss Donna Carter said that 2018 was gonna be a year of re-type words, that we were going to refresh, that we are going to renew, that we are going to replenish, that we are going to refocus, that we are going to realign. And wow, was that true. If you think about 2018 and all the messages that have come forth that God has blessed us with, it's been about faith, strengthening our faith. You guys, yeah, strengthening our faith, right? And being obedient to his word and his call and his purpose for your life. But it's about knowing that it's for his name's sake. Everything that we do is for his name's sake. If you think about 2018 and all the messages that have come forth, it has been about understanding the power and the authority that we wield inside of our hearts and our spirits. And it's nothing that we can do in our flesh, but it's the power that lives within us, the light of the world that lives within us, and understanding the call and hearing the call. It's been a year of fertilizing soil, to enriching our spirits so that we can not only just hear the word, but to be doers of the word, to let it impact our hearts and impact our minds and impact our soul, our very being. That's what 2018 was about. That's what 2018 was about. Positioning us, repositioning us. Amen? Refocusing us to his call. It's been a realignment. Whenever shifting happens in the atmosphere, you know, is prophesied in our prayer focus group. Actually, the prayer focus group also began in 2018. And let's give God the glory for that, because it has been a remarkable move. Let's give him some praise and some glory. And for Melanie Gibson stepping into that call and saying, I'm going to lead this prayer focus group so that we could all align together and realign to what God is doing. Amen? There's breakthrough that was on the cusp. See, we've been sowing seeds in 2018. And actually, even before that, and Melanie mentioned it, and Pastor Tim mentioned it all the time, that the best is yet to come. And so 2018 was a preparation year. We were sowing seeds, fertilizing soil, nourishment, stepping out in faith, stepping out in obedience to what God has for our life. Amen? And he has an awesome and incredible season ahead for 2019. And I hope that you're in a position to receive it and to listen and hear the call. So for the past 3 years, and it's so great that Melanie brought this up earlier when she was doing our assignment, is for the last 3 years, I've been giving myself a word of the year. And this word gave me a long-term focus for what my whole year is going to look like. There's something about having a long-term focus and a long-term vision for your life. But it wasn't anything that I chose on my own. See, it was in aligning with God's word, aligning with what he has and his will and purpose for my life. So it wasn't anything that I chose, but it was something that was chosen for me. And so that first year, the word of the year was sacrifice. Sacrifice. See, I knew and God knew that I needed to start giving up some things. I needed to refocus and sacrifice part of me. And that's what we're all called to do, to give up ourselves. When we become born again Christians, we give up ourselves and we follow in God's footsteps and the ordered step that he has before us. Amen? That's what it's all about. So that year, I spent every time I was... I noticed that everything I was trying to do, I was living a lifestyle of a palms down approach. So I said, God, I don't want to just be fed on Sunday. I want to sacrifice my whole week to you. Every moment of every day is sacrificed to you. And I know that Pastor has a word for me in this time in my season and that year. And I'm going to receive that word. I'm going to let it impact my heart. But it wasn't just that. God wanted me to open my eyes and open my ears to what he has to say to me, not just on a Sunday, but through every circumstance that I encountered on a daily basis. To my walk with you in our Bible study class, everything I said, give me, I just want to be available. And so the end of that year, as I sacrificed and I saw the power and the glory and the blessings that can come forth when you just give up yourself. See, what he showed me was the things that I thought I wanted in life, that I thought I needed in life, that whole year when I was saying sacrifice those things, what ended up happening at the end of the year when it was time to think about the new word for the next year, I said, you know what? I don't need to go back to those things. I really didn't want them. I really didn't need them. What I understand, what my eyes were open to and what my heart was open to is that God, the ways of God, the way of God is so much better than anything that I can ever imagine and ever want or ever need. Amen? So that second year, the word, as I began to sacrifice things, opportunity came. Opportunity came to witness. Opportunity came to do the work of God. Amen? But I didn't want to burn out. I've heard so many stories about burnout. I've heard so many stories about people quitting the ministry because they are just overwhelmed. And I knew that that was going to be the next word for 2016. I said, Lord, what's my word? And he confirmed that with capacity. I want to widen your capacity. I'm like, yes, that's it. I was in agreement with God. I'm going to widen my capacity so I can take and I can handle and not get burnout in anything that you throw my way. And that when you make that choice, when you take that step forward, when you make that commitment, he will fulfill the promise. Amen? He will fulfill the promise. So that was that year I said, and he gave me opportunity to walk in places that I have never walked before and to trust him completely. So then this past year, I prayed for my word for the year was depth. I didn't want to just have width. I didn't want to be a surface level Christian. I wanted to go deep. I wanted my roots to dig deep into the ground and latch hold of the word of God, the foundation of my faith, that Jesus Christ saved me. And he saved each and every one of the Christians here today. Amen? Amen. So this is what 2018 was about, going deeper. In 2019, this past couple weeks, I've been praying and seeking God. I said, God, what do you have for my life? And something really interesting happened, and this is why I'm sharing this with you. Something happened because the prayer and the word that I got, the vision that I have for my life in 2019, the Holy Spirit said, this is not just for you. This is for this church. This is for everybody here today. And that word is harvest. Amen. Y'all better celebrate. That is harvest time. Turn to your neighbor and say, it's harvest time. Say, it's harvest time. Amen. Amen. So it's harvest season. So 2019, all the stuff that you've been sowing in your life, the calling that is within you is going to come to the surface. See, we've been cultivating the land. We've been enriching the soil. In 2019, we are called into a harvest season as a church. Woo, thank the Lord. The harvest. The harvest is here. Amen? So it's not just the harvest time. 2019 is a season of goodness. So it's a season of goodness because God wants to show us his goodness. He wants us to see, taste, and see. So we're not just hearing about his goodness, we're actually seeing it come to pass. So the things that you have prayed over in your life, the things that we have prayed over in the church are going to come to pass in 2019. The best is yet to come is right around the corner. So 2019 is a year that God wants to show his goodness. You can taste it and you'll see it in the blessings that are going to come forth. It's also a season of new birth. It's a season of things that have been building up inside of you, the call that God has had on your life. Every single one of us has a gift, and that's why we've been in 2018 learning about our spiritual gifts, because God has a purpose for you, and you're going to walk in those gifts, and there's a new birth that's happening. So the word of God says, behold, I will do a new thing, and it shall spring forth. It shall spring forth. Shall you not know it? I'll even make a way in the wilderness and rivers in the desert. Amen? But just like it says in Revelation 12, anytime a new birth comes forth, the enemy is waiting to devour it. And so you have to protect it. So 2018 was also a season of spiritual warfare, and that's not going to end. The harvest is here, but also the spiritual warfare. Anytime you walk into new territory, you're going to have the resistance of the enemy come into your life and try to take it away from you. But we're not going to let it happen because we're ready for him. We're ready for him because we know who we are and the power that we have that lives inside of us. Amen? I've been excited about this word. I don't know if y'all can tell. John 4. Let's go ahead and open up our... That was just the introduction. John 4. And this is part of that sister passage that I spoke on 2 weeks ago from Isaiah 60. And so John 4, 35 through 38. Do you not say there are still 4 months and then comes the harvest? Behold, I say to you, lift up your eyes and look at the fields, for they are already white for harvest. Do you not say there are still 4 months and then comes the harvest? Isn't that what we often do? See, we are oftentimes servant to our schedules. And we cram our schedules, just like Brother Victor said here. We are so focused and have our eyes down on what we want to do, and we schedule every second of every single day. I've said it before. I'll say it again. And we look down on our phones, and we swipe, and we're not paying attention. God wants us to look up and see. He wants us to look, take the eyes from off of ourselves and actually look, raise our eyes up and see. 2019 is a year of harvest, but it doesn't mean that the harvest is not already here. It's not that, let's just wait. So we got, a few days so we can relax? The harvest is coming in 2019. No, the harvest has been here. And we just haven't looked up and seen the harvest. Amen? And so God wants us to stop saying, when somebody comes to you and says, can you pray for me? I say, yes, absolutely. We have Monday night prayer is when we'll pray for people. No, God is giving you the opportunity to step into that harvest, to get those blessings, to reap the blessings, to be an impact on somebody's lives, on somebody's soul. And wants you to be present. He wants you to be present. And you don't have to schedule prayer time. Somebody wants prayer, you just pray for them. Amen? Do you not say there are still 4 months and then comes the harvest? Behold, I say to you, lift up your eyes and look at the fields, for they are already white for harvest. The harvest. There are uncharted territories that we haven't walked in. So unharvested fields that are just waiting for us to harvest them. The harvester of souls, Jesus Christ, wants us to labor with him in this harvesting. And he who reaps receives wages and gathers fruit for eternal life. He who sows and he who reaps may rejoice together. For in this the saying is true, one sows and another reaps. I sent you to reap that for which you have not labored. Others have labored, and you have entered into their labors. And so it's easy for when we talk about a new thing that God wants to do, a new thing, and it's just like we have to respect people have labored in this field before us. See, we are reaping benefits today because somebody was obedient to the word of God and his will. Pastor Claude Hurley, who started this church, said, I will be that vessel. I will harvest the field. I will walk into this labor. And then after about 20 years, it was passed off to Pastor Tim. And around 20 years, he labored. And there are some people who labored in here. And we are reaping the benefits today because of those people who have labored in the past. So, yes, we need to be focused on God and what he has for us. We don't need to schedule our religious traditions, but we need to be open, but we also need to respect and look at the things that have gotten here in the first place. Amen? that both he who sows and he who reaps may rejoice together. So we're all rejoicing. For in this the saying is true, one sows and another reaps. I sent you to reap that for which you have not labored. Others have labored and you have entered into their labor. So he sent you. Do you believe that you were sent here today? Now you made a choice. And when you choose, your path is straight. Your path is ordered. But when you choose, but you have been sent here. You have been sent here for a purpose. Amen? And so we have entered into their labors. Into their labors. Not entered into, you know, just sitting around and just waiting for somebody else to do it. We've entered into their labors. So I want to focus on the sending. Luke 10, 1 through 11. This is Jesus sending out the 70. And after these things, the Lord appointed 70 others also and sent them two by two before his face into every city and place where he himself was about to go. See, he was about to go to the places. And so he sent out 70 to represent him before his face and to bless those people because he believed in multiplication. Jesus believes in multiplication. And so he sends out these open and obedient servants to go to places that he himself was about to go. And then he said to them, the harvest truly is great, but the laborers are few. The harvest truly is great, but the laborers are few. It is my prayer for this church that we will desire to be a part of the few laborers. Let me say that again. It is my prayer that we will desire as a church to be a part of the few laborers. Amen? Amen? Amen. And, you know, it's so easy for us to sit idly by and to come to church and to sit and say, you know what? We need to have this ministry because this ministry is what God's calling into. So I just pray that somebody will start that ministry over there because God wants to do something. He's calling us to labor. And labor isn't always easy. Actually, it's not easy. If my wife were here today, Greer has a fever. So she's out today. I'm sure she's watching online. Thank the Lord for the live stream. I forgot my point. I was so concerned about Greer. Labor pains, that's what it was. Woo! We know labor isn't easy. And I just know from secondhand knowledge, not firsthand knowledge, but the great thing about labor is, and I'm sure my wife would echo this, that it's tough and it's painful, and you go through it and it's strenuous. But on the other side of the labor, the other side of the labor is a blessing, is a gift that you wouldn't trade for the world. And I'm hesitating to say this, but you would almost want to go through it again in order to get a new blessing. Amen? And a new gift. So labor isn't easy, but the harvest truly is great, but the laborers are few. Therefore, pray the Lord of the harvest to send out laborers into his harvest. And that's easy to be an external prayer, isn't it? Lord of the harvest, I pray that you send somebody else out. So I pray that you send somebody else. Like this couple that goes to this church, they're doing an awesome job over there with outreach, and they're doing great things in the community. I pray that they come over here. And we can pray those prayers. But what God is truly saying, what the Word is truly saying, you got to look inside. You got to look inside. When you feel the call, when you feel that purpose, when God is speaking to you saying, you know, this ministry is new charted territory and somebody needs to step into it, you need to be that person that steps into that and says, God, I am present. I don't know what I'm doing. I don't even know where to start, but I know that you, God, are going to give me everything that I need. You are going to give me everything that I need to be successful because you have planted the seed in my heart. And if I don't know what I'm doing and I'm still a little hesitant, I'm going to work to know what I'm going to do. And I may not know it, but then I have to take a leap of faith to just walk into that. He's going to equip you. If you are called, he's going to give you everything that you need in order to fulfill his will. Amen? So it's an external prayer. And Lord, we do need to pray for people to come in. Because we do need those laborers to come into this house. But we also need to step into that labor. Go your way. Behold, I send you out as lambs among wolves. Carry neither money bag, knapsack, nor sandals, and greet no one along the road. That doesn't sound very Christian. You're walking along, somebody's trying to greet you on the road. It's not very Christian to not even greet them and keep walking forward. But what it's saying here, he's saying, go your way. I have given you an assignment. And I want you to have laser focus. I want you to have laser focus. You know what? Don't bring a knapsack. Don't bring that junk. You don't need anything. What I want you to do is focus. Don't even bring your sandals. I'm going to give you everything that you need. Don't bring your money. Just walk in faith because I'm going to provide for you. And I want you to be laser focused because of the assignment that I have for you. Don't get distracted. Don't look down. Look up. Look up. Focus on his face. Focus on the assignment. Go your way. Make a beeline. Don't look back. Don't look to the side. Because wolves, you'll greet them on the way. Don't greet them. They'll try to greet you. They'll try to distract you. Don't be distracted. Keep on moving forward. Don't let them knock you off. Don't let them knock you off of the track. Be realigned with God and his purpose for your life. Hallelujah. I send you out as lambs among wolves. Carry neither money bag, knapsack, nor sandals, and greet no one along the road. But whatever house you enter, first say peace to this house, and if a son of peace is there, your peace will rest on it. If not, it will return to you. And remain in the same house, eating and drinking such things as they give, for the laborer is worthy of his wages. Do not go from house to house. Whatever city you enter and they receive you, eat such things as are set before you, and heal the sick there. And say to them, the kingdom of God has come near to you. But whatever city you enter and they do not receive you, go out into the streets and say, the very dust of your city which clings to us, we wipe off against you. Nevertheless, know this, that the kingdom of God has come near. Jesus. Kingdom of God has come near. And we have to receive the kingdom of God. We got to seek after the manifest presence of Jesus. Now, it'll come near to us. The kingdom of God will come right beside us, right along us, but we have to take the step into the kingdom of God, into the labor. Because if not, if we don't step into it, if we're not obedient to God's call, what is going to happen? If you don't receive it, then what you're actually doing is rejecting it. And if you're rejecting it, it's going to keep on going. The Holy Spirit is going to move. It's up to us to move with it, light on our toes, not to bring our sandals. Take all the stuff that we don't need that junk. Get it off. Stay focused. Step into it. You've been called. You're here for a reason. It's not just to pay bills. Amen. It's not just to pay bills. You're here for a work. You're here for a purpose. So the kingdom of God has come near to you. Okay, all right, Wes. I've been sitting idly by for so long. I'm finally going to do it. I'm going to do it. I hear what God is saying to me. I'm letting it saturate my soul. But what if I mess up? What if I want to be able to witness to people, but what if I approach that opportunity that you're giving me, and what if I approach it and I say the wrong things? See, there's too much at stake. I don't want to mess it up, so I'm just going to pray that one of the few will go and minister to them. I don't want to mess it up. God is with you. I said it a couple weeks ago. Jesus Christ is with you. He's the God of the hills and he's the God of the valleys. He'll equip you and give you everything that you need. Isaiah 43:1-3. But now thus says the Lord, who created you, O Jacob, and he who formed you, O Israel, and he who formed you, Gospel Temple, fear not, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by your name. You are mine. When you pass through the waters, I will be with you. And through the rivers, they shall not overflow you. When you walk through the fire, you shall not be burned, nor shall the flame scorch you. For I am the Lord your God, the Holy One of Israel, your Savior. He's with you, church. He's with you, right there. You're not going to drown. You're not going to be overwhelmed. He's going to give you everything that you need, every tool, every word. It's planting seeds, sowing seeds, walking in faith, sowing seeds into other people's lives, into your life. Keep sowing seeds, cultivating. He loves you. He's not going to abandon you. He's not going to leave you. He's there. That's something to celebrate. No matter what happens in life, no matter how bad you fail, no matter how much you succeed, no matter what trials come your way or triumphs, we're in this together. And God is with you. And the awesome thing about if I'm just so thankful for Brother Craig Young, who's obedient to the call. Last minute, the Lord put it on his heart to minister to the folks out in Timminsville. And so last minute, a chain of communication went out to people. How can we get involved? And people were eager. And I pray for more of that out of this church. Last minute. This is something on my heart, but it's tomorrow. I don't think we can have time. So maybe next year. Isn't there 4 months till harvest? Next year. But what about, let's try to do it tomorrow. Let's bear one another's burdens. Let's come to the table. Because he wants to bless us. So that's why we don't have any sandals on. That's why we don't have money. That's why we don't have our knapsack full of stuff that we think that we need. He wants us to be agile and present in the moment and faithful and obedient. Galatians 6:7-10. Do not be deceived. God is not mocked. For whatever a man sows, that he will also reap. For he who sows to his flesh will of the flesh reap corruption. But he who sows to the Spirit will of the Spirit reap everlasting life. And let us not grow weary while doing good, for in due season we shall reap if we do not lose heart, if we do not give up, if we don't lose hope, And we continue the work, continue sowing the seed, continue sowing the seed, reaping the harvest, working in the fields. The harvest is massive. It's truly great. And we have to continue the work day in and day out and being present and obedient to God's call, understanding that the power that we have, our identity in Him, He's with us. He's with us all the time. And we are called to burn. We're called to burn as a bright light. And He will burn. He will shine. He's the light of the world. It says in the Bible that the light that radiates from Jesus Christ Himself is brighter than the sun. We won't even need the sun. And let us not grow weary while doing good, for in due season we shall reap if we do not lose heart. Therefore, as we have opportunity, let us do good to all, especially to those who are the household of faith. Amen. Hallelujah. Go ahead and stand to your feet. The incredible thing about this word is an on-time word. I'm so excited for 2019 and the harvest that we are about to labor into. He's going to show us His goodness. We're going to taste it, and we're going to see it. And our eyes have been open, and our ears have been open, and we have to continue to be faithful in that. But the really cool thing about this is Jesus and God are one. And I pray I get the opportunity to speak another message I have about unity among believers. But Jesus and God are one. And so as you align yourself with Jesus, you're aligning yourself with God. So you and God are one. And the great thing is, other people in the household of faith are also united as one with God. So we bear each other's burdens. The call is not just for one person. The call is for all of us. Because if one person hears from God, hears from the will of God, and gets the assignment, we have to jump at the opportunity to partake in the labor of that assignment. Are you willing? Are you willing? Yes. Seth, I love you, brother. So what we're going to do, the remainder of the service, we're actually, let's play some music up there really low. Real low. Thank you so much. So what I want to do is I want to give us an opportunity for those who don't know Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior. Who don't know Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior. Their eyes are open to what this possibly could mean for them. To know that you have a purpose and a gift, a spiritual gift that lives inside of you. I want to give you the opportunity to step forward here today. So by the raise of hand, anyone here, I want to give their life over to Jesus because it is a sacrifice. Okay. So secondly, I want anyone who has something that God has been trying to unlock. That God has been trying to open the door. This burden that's been placed on your heart. This vision. This gift on your life. I want you to go ahead and come to the altar here this morning. Now God's been speaking to you. God has been speaking to all of us. Come on. Come on. Don't wait any longer. The ripe harvest is truly great. The souls, the blessing is on the other side. The blessing is on the other side. Just give it to God. Make this a bold declaration that today is the day that I'm going to step forward in obedience. And I'm going to step forward, God. I'm making the choice. I'm making the choice. I see the assignment. I'm refocused on you, God. I'm refocused on it, God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Let's pray. Let's pray over it. Actually, let's have everybody else come in support of the gifts and the call that is on their life. I want to go ahead and make a bold declaration here today that you will begin to pray over these callings, that we will stand in agreement with God and what He wants to do over this church. And 2018 is coming to a close. And 2019, the harvest is near. Let's go ahead and begin to pray over these. Heavenly Father, thank you so much. Thank you so much for your blessings. Thank you so much for all that you do to us, that you do for us. We praise you, we honor you, we glorify you in everything that we do, and we want to be obedient to the call. We want to be obedient and realign and come in agreement with what you have for us, God. We're so thankful for the sacrifice that you gave in your only begotten Son, the light of the world. Hallelujah, hallelujah. We are so thankful for what you're going to continue to do, that you are going to unleash blessing amongst this congregation, that you're going to unleash blessing among this congregation, that you're going to unlock the blessings and unlock the power that is inside each and every one of us. And we pray to you, God, and we love you, and we're so thankful for the love that you give us day in and day out. God, we honor you. God, we give you all the praise and all the glory. It's not for us. It's for you, God. And so as we continue to just worship you here this morning, as we continue to pray over one another and come in agreement with what you're doing here at this church, God, I just thank you, God. I thank you, Father, for protecting us. I thank you, God, for giving us the opportunity to walk in spiritual warfare, because it's your battle, God. It's your battle that we are coming in alignment with and agreement with, that we will be vessels of light that are going to move in this place, that we are going to go outside of the walls, and you're going to send us out, God, and we are going to minister and be the vessels and before your face, God, that we are going to impact our city and reach into uncharted territories, God. We are so thankful for what you're doing, God. We're so thankful for the blessings and your love for us, God. And I pray that you love, that you continue to love us, God. And we know that you will, but we also pray that we will love one another just as we love ourselves, God. That we will love with all of our heart, all of our body, all of our soul, all of our spirit. That we will love you completely. And the outpouring of that, the overflow of that, is going to be that we are going to then love our neighbors as ourselves. And we begin to serve, not for anything that we want to do, because you have sent us, God. And it is your will. And we are so thankful for it. God, I pray over these people. I pray over everybody here and everybody who is a part of this fellowship. I pray for everybody who is going to be a part of this fellowship, that you are going to unlock the gates and people are going to flow into our presence, God. And I pray for the opportunity for all of us to be obedient to the call, that we will pray and care over one another, and we will be a loving church, continue to be a loving church, God. And we are so thankful. We're so thankful. We're so thankful for the gifts that you have given us, the gift of salvation, the gift of grace, the gift, the spiritual gifts that live inside of us. And I pray that they're unleashed and unlocked, and that we will begin to overflow in the power, that we'll begin to overflow, and that we will be able to step into healing one another in your name and meeting the needs in your name. It is your name's sake. And we give you all the glory, all the honor, and every single ounce of our praise in Jesus' name. And God's people said, amen. Amen, amen. Amen, amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God, thank you so much. Thank you so much. Let's give him a hand clap of praise here this morning. Thank you so much. Come on. And remember, 5 o'clock, the members meeting here at the church. Love you guys.
triumph unfolds. He's never failing. He's never failing.
You'll show.